So here with Lucy Marks, the artist, painter, and also you're going to be exhibiting artwork, aren't you, at Petworth Help? We're going to talk about that a bit later on. First of all, we're going to talk a bit about your career. Okay. Lucy, I know you started off as a counsellor, so tell us a bit about how you became to be a painter that's now going to be... exhibiting at Petworth House. It's quite a big achievement.
Yeah, so I suppose my art career has been a bit varied and how I've ended up where I am. I grew up in an artistic family. My mum was an artist, and so I grew up around paint, which is a bit like an apprenticeship, really. So, I was used to her exhibiting a lot. And then, I grew up in the Brighton area, moved away, started to train as a counsellor. My actual day job for 20 years was really a counsellor. And I kind of wanted to kind of help people, I suppose, help themselves. So it was a long time working as a counsellor. And alongside that, I always painted. And over the years, what happened was my painting became more and more successful. And I went from being a full-time counsellor to a part-time counsellor. Then I went off and did my MA at Brighton University in Fine Art. And now I'm a full-time painter. And so it's been a progression, really. And I feel very fortunate that I can fulfil a dream of painting all the time.
Because it's a dream that a lot of people want to achieve, isn't it? They want to be a kind of a full-time painter. You've managed to do it, though. That's a lot of hard work. I know you did, like, 5 hours painting even when you were a counsellor.
Yeah.
So that's...
I think you have to treat it as a job. You know, if you want to be serious about it, you have to look at it as a job. And so I'm a bit of an early bird. I'm usually in my studio, which is in my house, for 7 o'clock in the morning. And I paint all the way to late lunch, mid-afternoon, most days, if I'm not out with my pochard. So I have a little pochard, which is like a portable easel. And I'll go out into the countryside and I'll paint outside for a whole day as well. And I'll do little oils or watercolours, bring them back, and they're either standalone works in themselves, or I actually work from them for much bigger works in the studio. So I think if you're going to take it on as a career, you have to kind of really think about it quite seriously. And I have a little saying, it's all about miles on the brush. The more you do, the better you get, and the more ingrained you get at it. And it doesn't just happen.
And it's landscapes, isn't it, a lot of your work? Why landscapes?
Yeah. Well, I'm a contemporary landscape painter. You're right there, Mark. And I think, for me, I'm very drawn to nature. I think we're incredibly fortunate to live between the sea and the downs. And both are huge sources of inspiration for me. And I love to see the joy in nature, and my aim is for people to have the joy from my paintings and a joy and a connection back to nature. And if they get that from my work, then I feel I've achieved the job.
Yeah, exactly. And so what kind of paintings, what kind of areas do you kind of focus on then? Do you have certain topics?
Yeah, so during lockdown, the very, very first lockdown, I had been going out sketching in the landscape. And what I'd been doing is I'd been working on 5 National Trust sites all in our area, like Cissbury Ring, Ditchling Beacon. And I was working on those as sketches. Then when lockdown came, I worked each of those areas up into oils and watercolours and put a whole exhibition online about them. And so for me, I like to pick an area and a theme and really work through it, sketch it, paint it, go out and walk in it and then paint it, and then bring them back to the studio and paint some more. So I suppose I stick to different areas. They tend to be around here because this is where I live. But I have excursions sometimes down to Cornwall and things. So yes. Yeah.